हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू डिजिटल लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म स्मार्ट स्टडी बाय आकिबर हमदानी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इंटरनेशनल इक्विटी मार्केट अंडर मॉड्यूल 4, सब्जेक्ट इंटरनेशनल फाइनेंस, जीटीयू एमबीए। आई डिवाइडेड दिस टॉपिक इनटू टू पार्ट्स। दिस इज द फर्स्ट पार्ट इन विच आई कवर्ड इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ इंटरनेशनल इक्विटी मार्केट एंड टाइप्स ऑफ इंटरनेशनल इक्विटी मार्केट। Here there are two types of international equity market. First one is Euro currency market and Euro credit market. I also covered their features, their positive effect and negative effects. So students, simplest definition of international equity market is issued floated by foreign companies in the domestic equity market is known as foreign equity market. International equity markets are an important platform for global finance. They do not only ensure the participation of a wide variety of participants, but also offer global economies to be financially successful. To understand the importance of international equity markets, market valuation and turnovers are important tools. Moreover, we must also learn how these markets are composed and the elements that govern them. There are four elements: gross listing, Yankee stocks, ADRs, and DRS are important elements of equity markets. In this tutorial, we will discuss all these aspects along with the return from the international equity markets. Before discussing the elements of international equity market, we will discuss about types of international equity market. There are two types of international equity markets. First one is Euro currency market and second one is Euro credit market. Let's discuss about Euro currency market. The term Euro currency market describes deposit of currencies which are owned by non-residents of the country, whose legal tender the currency is and which are lent by the owner. For example, a bank in Japan whose account with a New York bank is credited with US dollar from an external sources would be in possession of Euro dollar. The Japanese bank would be in position to lend it anywhere in the world at a comparatively higher rate of interest to those who would like to borrow dollars. Here are some features of Euro currency market. The first one is, it is an international market. The Euro currency market is an international market which accepts deposits and give credit in currencies from throughout the world. Another feature is, it is an independent market. It is a free and independent market which does not function under the control of any monetary authority. It is also a wholesale market. It is a wholesale market in which different currencies are bought and sold, usually above $1 million. The another feature of Euro currency market is, it is a short-term market. It is a short-term money market in which deposits in different currencies are usually accepted for a period ranging from a few days to a year, and interest is paid on them. Another feature is interbank market. It is an interbank market in which the Euro banks borrow and lend dollars and other Euro currencies from each other. There are some positive effects of Euro currency market. First one, the expansion of the Euro currency market has greatly increased international capital mobility and has helped in easing the global liquidity problems. Second, Euro currency market has helped in integrating international capital market also. Third one, Euro currency market has played an effective role in recycling funds from countries having surplus balance of payment to those having deficit balance of payments. Another positive effect of Euro currency markets are, international flows of Euro currencies have improved economic efficiency by reducing interest differential among the nations. The euro currency market has also resolved the problems of countries whose policy objective aim to control international capital movement by transferring their currencies from and to euro banks. There are some adverse effects of euro currency market also. However, this flow of euro currencies have three adverse effects also. First, when the monetary authority of the country is trying to curb inflation through a restriction of monetary policy, an inflow of short-term capital deficit to such policies. This is because the euro currency market does not operate under the regulation of any authority. The second adverse effect of euro currency market is euro currencies provide an enormous fund of liquid resources which are used for speculative capital movement. This exposes the economies of concerned countries to severe strains of sudden and large withdrawal of credit. Such financial upheavals and disturbances also affect the international monetary system as a whole, especially when the countries involved are not protected by exchange controls or trade barriers. According to Milton Friedman, the euro currency market has almost surely raised the world's nominal money supply and has thus made the world's price level high. Now the topic is euro credit market. Euro credit refers to a loan whose denominated currency is not the lending bank's national currency. The concept is closely linked to the euro currency, which is any currency held or traded outside its country of issue. For example, a euro dollar is a dollar deposited, held or traded outside the US. And conversely, a euro credit loan made by a US bank would be one that is not denominated in the US dollar. There are some features of euro credit market. Euro credit are short or to medium term loans of euro currency extended by euro banks to corporations, sovereign governments, non-prime banks or international organizations. The second feature is euro credit loans are usually given to the large corporates of governments who request them. The loans are denominated in the currencies other than the home currencies of the euro bank. Euro currency loans carry variable rates. And fifth, on euro credits originated in London, the base lending rate is LIBOR. There are some benefits of euro credit market. In the euro credit market, funds can be raised by non-borrower very quickly in the euro currency market. Second, euro currency loan with a multi-currency clause enables the borrowers to switch currencies on any rollover period. The interest rate charged for these loans are based on LIBOR, London Interbank Offered Rate. Fourth, This helps for capital flows between countries and helps the increase liquidity of both currencies and adjust foreign market risk. Fifth, this also helps to finance the domestic investment and investments abroad. So friends, if you have any query, you can ask me in comments or contact me through the following paths. The remaining part of this topic we will discuss about in the next video. Thank you so much.